Hi, I'm Doug Soltis. I'm a distinguished professor in the Department of Biology here at the University of Florida. I'm also an affiliate curator with the Florida Museum of Natural History. And we're here today to tell you a bit about the Amborella Genome Project, a project that is funded by the National Science Foundation and a project that we're very much involved with here at the University of Florida. So why Amborella? Why sequence the genome of this plant that is only found on the island of New Caledonia? Well, Amborella is a very important flowering plant because it sits at the base of the tree of life of all of the 350,000 or so species of flowering plants. So that's a very important or pivotal position. It makes it an important reference point for all other flowering plants. In a sense, it's our best window into what the earliest flowering plants that are now extinct might have looked like and what their genomes might have been like. So we're sequencing the genome of this plant because of its importance evolutionarily, and it will provide information and critical insights into the genomes of all other flowering plants, such as many of our crop plants, such as rice and corn and wheat, beans, cucumber. Those plants, those flowering plants, are all quite modified or derived evolutionarily compared to the genome of Amborella. Hence the interest in the Amborella genome as a reference or a point of comparison.
Hi, I'm Pam Soltis. I'm a distinguished professor and curator of the Laboratory of Molecular Systematics and Evolutionary Genetics at the Florida Museum of Natural History at the University of Florida. We've been interested in Amborella for about 15 years now. We've been trying to reconstruct the evolutionary history of the flowering plants for the better part of the last 20 years. And about 15 years ago, through some of the analyses that we were conducting, we determined that Amborella occupies this important pivotal location in the family tree of flowering plants. About the last 10 years, we've been working on various aspects of the genome properties of Amborella through a set of collaborations with some colleagues at other institutions, most notably at Penn State, the University at Buffalo, and the University of Georgia. And through these projects, we've learned already quite a bit about the genome of Amborella, some of its properties, and some of the genes that are important in encoding features such as the flower. And we're hoping that by building on this past research, we'll be able to get a much better understanding of how the flowering plants have evolved. And to tell you a little bit more about how this project will work, I'll turn things over to Brad.
Hi, I'm Brad Barbozak. I am an assistant professor with the University of Florida and a member of the University of Florida Genetics Institute. My role in the Amborella project is actually twofold. I will be involved both in the assembly of the genome as well as in its annotation, in other words, the identification of functional units or genes within the DNA sequence. Our strategy will be to do a random sequencing, whole genome shotgun sequencing, which basically means we will take the genome, smash it up into little pieces, and sequence it. Once we have all these genes, they will serve as landmarks, and they will allow us to compare the Amborella genome to the genome of other flowering plants. And this will give us a great deal of insight into how the other flowering plants' genomes have evolved over the ages.